हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, नमस्कार टू एवरीवन। आई सेल्फ मुकेश सिपाल, असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर स्कूल ऑफ एग्रीकल्चर, आईटी यूनिवर्सिटी ग्वालियर। सो टुडे वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट द डिफरेंशिएशन ऑफ एक्स टू द पावर एन ए टू द पावर एक्स बाय द फर्स्ट प्रिंसिपल ऑफ द डिफरेंशिएशन। सो दिस इज द टॉपिक ऑफ यूनिट टू, a subject that is elementary mathematics, whose code is STAT111. This is the lecture number 7 of this subject. So in today's lecture we will discuss the differentiation of x to the power n by the first principle, differentiation of x square by the first principle, differentiation of e to the power x by the first principle. So these are the topics that we will discuss today. So firstly we will differentiate x to the power n by the first principle of differentiation. So we have given fx is equal to x to the power n. Okay, then f x plus h equal to, in place of x we will write x plus h and its power is n. The differentiation of fx is f dash x, and here something missing, that is limit h tends to 0 f x plus h minus fx upon h. This is the formula of differentiation of a function by the first principle of the differentiation. Here again we will write limit h tends to 0 f x plus, the value of function f x plus h is x plus h to the power n minus, what is the value of f x, that is x to the power n, and it is divided by h. So we write here it is divided by h. The expansion of x plus h to the power n by binomial theorem is nc0 x to the power n plus nc1 x to the power n minus 1 into h plus dot 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 plus ncn h to the power n dot dot dot, means these sequence will be repeated ahead. This is the meaning of this dot dot dot. Then we write f dash x is equal to limit h tends to 0 x plus h to the power n minus x to the power n divided by h. The expansion of this, the value of nc0 is 1, that is multiplied with x to the power n. So 1 multiplied to the x to the power n is x to the power n. So this will be subtracted by this x to the power n, so that will be 0. Okay, then the answer of nc1 is n. Okay, its answer is n, and this value will be similar, x to the power n minus 1, and this h will be same. Value of ncn will be 1, and this h to the power n will be written as it is. Okay, then we take this h as common. So this whole term will be 0 when it is subtracted from x to the power n. Its answer is n. So we write this n and x to the power n minus 1 here, and this h will be taken at the outside. Then we write this plus and dot dot, this plus and dot dot, then plus. The answer of this is 1, and 1 is multiplied to the h to the power n, then it is h to the power n. When h is taken at the outside, so now what is the remaining that is inside, that is h to the power n minus 1. When h to the power n minus 1 is multiplied with h, its power is 1. When in multiplication the power will be added, so this minus 1 and this 1 is cancelled. What is remaining? Only h to the power n, that is this. So we have taken h as common, so due to that the thing that is remaining inside this bracket, that is h to the power n minus 1, and it is divided by h, this. So this h and this h will be cancelled. Now we have to put the value of h as 2 0, means its value is 0. So when we put this h 0, so this term will be 0. What is remaining? N x to the power n minus 1. So this is the final answer of this question. And we know the differentiation of x to the power n is nx to the power n minus 1. So the formula, that formula is comes from this first principle of the differentiation. Okay, so we will move to the next question of this topic. Now we have to find the derivative of fx is equal to x to the power 3 by the first principle of the differentiation. Okay, so we know the formula of first principle of the differentiation is f dash x is equal to limit h tends to 0 fx plus h minus fx upon h. Your fx is your x to the power 3, but we have to find f x plus h. Okay, so in place of x we have to write x plus h, and its power is 3. Okay, so here that is f x plus h. So here we write x plus h to the power 3. Then it is minus. So we write here this minus and fx. Fx means x to the power 3. And it is divided by h. And this is x plus h to the power 3. We know the formula a plus b whole cube is equal to a cube plus b cube plus 3ab and in bracket a plus b. This is the formula of a plus b whole cube. We have to apply this formula here. This is your a, x, and h is your b. Okay, a cube means x cube, b cube matlab h cube, plus 3ab, 3 into x into h, into a plus b. A means x and b means h. Then it is minus, so we write here this minus, and x to the power 3, this is your x to the power 3, and it is divided by h. So it is divided by h. So now this x to the power 3 and this x to the power 3 will be cancelled because it is minus and this is plus. After that we have to divide this h in whole numerator. So h to the power 3, it is divided by h, so it becomes h to the power 2. Then this h and this h will be cancelled, so what is remaining? Only 3x. Then x plus h. Now the limit is h tends to 0. Means we have to put the value of h is 0. So when this value of h is 0, so this will be 0. And this h is also 0. This 3x is multiplied with this x and becomes 3x square. And we know the differentiation of x to the power 3 is 3x square. So that formula comes from this first principle of the differentiation. Then differentiation of a to the power x by the first principle. We know the formula of differentiation of by the first principle, that is f dash x is equal to limit h tends to 0 f x plus h minus fx upon h. So here your fx is a to the power x. And function x plus h is a to the power. In place of x, we write x plus h. So here, this x plus h, we write e to the power x plus h. Then it is minus, so we write here this minus. And fx means e to the power x. And it is divided by h, so we write here it is divided by h. This is limit h tends to 0, so we write here limit h tends to 0. Similarly, we write here limit h tends to 0. And this power x to e to the power x plus h, we can also write it as e to the power x into e to the power h. Because in multiplication, power will be added. So when this power will be added, so it becomes e to the power x plus h. So this can be written as e to the power x into e to the power h. Then this minus, so we write this minus to the power x, e to the power x, it is divided by h, so it is divided by h. Now we can take e to the power x common, because that is here and that is here also. So what is remaining here? That is e to the power h. And minus, this is taken outside, so what is remaining here, that is only 1, and it is divided by h. Now this e to the power x is taken at the outside, and we write here limit h tends to 0 here. What is remaining? E to the power h minus 1 upon h. Now we take this one as a separate and solve this. This. So this 1 can be written as e to the power 0. When the when any power of any function is 0, then its answer is 1. So we can write 1 as e to the power 0. Remaining things are same. So this e to the power h can also be written as e to the power 0 plus h, because when we add 0 to any term, so there is no effect on that. So suppose this is your fx, okay, and this is your fx plus h. So the value of x is 0 here. So this can be written as function f 0, okay, and this is x plus h. Your x is already 0, and f 0 plus h. This, and it is divided by h. So So this is the first principle of your differentiation. Okay, and when the function, that is your fx, that is your e to the power x, here the value of x is 0 and the power of n is 0 and its answer is 1. So all this function, the value is 1. So this term can be written as f dash 0 because it is the differentiation of 0 e to the power 0 by the first principle. So e to the power x into f dash 0. So the value of this term is 1. When 1 is multiplied with this e to the power x, then your answer will be e to the power x. So the differentiation of e to the power x is to the power x. Okay. So after this you have an assignment. You have to differentiate x to the power n, e to the power x and x square by the first principle of the differentiation. So from this assignment we can I can take a question in your examination also. So these are the learning outcome of this lecture, and these are the references from where the material is taken, and thank you so much.